up? Boop. I feel naked. Without my earrings in. I feel like I haven't made a video in a while. A few things have changed. Like my hair again. I got bored! It's not my fault I get bored easily. Okay, maybe it is. Recently I went to the clothes show at the NEC in Birmingham and I got quite a few goodies that I want to talk you through. I'm going to try and make it relatively quick based on the fact that I've got band practice soon and I don't want to keep the boys waiting. Why late, Jess? I was making a YouTube video. Could have waited, Jess. Okay, so I'm going to get started. So I went to the clothes show with my mama and Dave. And it was quite a really, I don't know, it was a weird experience, but it was a fun experience at the same time. I've never been to the clothes show, so I didn't know what to expect. The only reason that I actually went this time was because I got a free pass from my agency, Spirit Model Management. And they put me in a drawer with all the rest of the models, and I was lucky enough to go. So I was like, yeah, I finally won something. So I went there, and I met up with Safira, and she gave me my pass, and I got in for free. It's shining near the lights. That's me. It looks like my hair's red, but it's actually pink. Whoop, 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 whoop. So yeah, I got this pass. And I've attached it to this keyring that I've got. This really, really cute little teddy bear thingy majiggy bob. And I've stuck it on my wall. So we got there, we went in, and there was all sorts of things. There was like a massive dance hall, which had like dance outfits, dancers, dancing tents, all kinds of things like that, dance schools, and they had these strippers there as well. It was hilarious because me and my mum, we saw these like pole dancers. Okay, they weren't strippers, they were pole dancers. I need to stop saying strippers when it comes to pole dancers. I always think it's the same thing. Yes, I'm aware it's not the same thing, blah blah blah, but I can't help it. Anyway, so yeah, so basically me and my mum saw these pole dancers and we were like, whoa, awesome. And me and my mum were stood there for ages just admiring these pole dancers. And my mate Dave, he's the boy, and he stood there like this. I mean, come on! Pole dancers! Show a bit more excitement than that! Anyway, so that was the first hall, and we walked around that, and blah blah blah. I do like to dance and stuff, and I used to do a lot of dancing in dance competitions and blah blah blah, but that wasn't really what I was interested in this time. I was more interested in finding the makeup section. Yes, I am aware it's called the clothes show, so it's more about clothes, but I know for a fact there would be makeup-based things there. So we went to the next section, and that had a big clothes section, hair section, and then that was it. I saw the makeup section, and I went crazy. Okay, I didn't go too crazy, but I wanted to go crazy, but I tried to limit myself. And one thing that I spotted was all these girls walking around with these bags. And as soon as I saw a Barry M bag, I went insane. I was so determined to find this Barry M stall. And when I finally found it, I was like, bah! Gotta love my Barry M. Bah! So yeah, so then I ran to this section, and when I found it, I was like, bah! This deal going, which is basically this bag, this cute little Barry M bag, that says, I love Barry M. It's all glittery, if you want to look. I need to stop moving the camera, I can't help it. Ah! Okay, anyway, so they had this deal, which was basically pay £10 and get 50 quid's worth of Barry M makeup. I was not going to complain, and I swear, if I had more money at the time, I probably would have done it twice. But yeah, I only did it once, and I got this cute little makeup bag full of stuff. So I'm going to show you some of the stuff that I got. Oh, it's already open, because I've been playing with the stuff in it. Okay. So I got 3 nail paints. Which were these ones. And as you can see, because I'm lovely like that, my nails that I'm actually wearing now, I'm wearing the colours on my nails here. I'm wearing this shiny blue here is this. This like yellowy green colour is this. And then obviously the silver kind of colour. What is that shadow coming from? It's pissing me off. Silver colour here. Is this 197 300? This is called acid yellow. The other one doesn't have a name, and then this last one was actually very similar to another one I have, and this is 217. And I found all 3 of these need 4 coats. 4 coats. So I got 3 nail paints, 2 lip glosses, super glossy shiny tube. Ooh, shiny. And this is in Fab 1. And then I got this, another glossy tube, which is another super shiny gloss. This one doesn't have a specific name at all. It's just super shiny lip gloss. Awesomeness. And it's a limited edition, apparently. I'll do a quick swatch of these because I'm nice. Okay, so this one is like, I found that this is a very peachy kind of pinky creamy colour. I can't speak today, it's annoying me. But yeah, really nice. This is obviously just like a very, very light reddy pink lip gloss or whatever. Just your typical gloss, nothing special. They don't really smell of anything, I'm going to be completely honest with you guys. They don't really smell. And my camera's wonky again. Today is not my day. Why? Why do you have to be wonky? Mr. Camera, I give up with you. I give up. Okay, I don't because I'm going to continue the video, but shh. It's 4 Dazzle Dusts. I got 29, which is like a very, very light yellowy gold. 83, which is like a, I don't know, your typical kind of tealy, greeny, blue colour, turquoisey kind of thing. This one's very similar to the nail polish, as in like, they're both roughly the same kind of colour. This one's slightly bluer than this one, I guess. 8, which is kind of like a highlighting white with gold shimmer. Am I not annoying you guys today? All I keep doing is moving the camera. I apologise! The last 3 things I got is I got another gloss. I forgot to mention this gloss. This is number 1 and it's just a shiny, shiny, glossy colour. Swatch you a bit of that. As you can see there, just a really, really shiny, clear gloss with bits of glitter in it. And then I also got this duo eyeliner. Oh, I wish the dog would just shush. Oh well. And there's some swatches of the colours that come out. Da-da-da-da-da. Then last but not least, I got this really funky green glitter eyeliner. I'm just going to talk while the dog's talking. Whatever! Just keep talking, Jessie. It's fine. Wish my dog would shush. I love her, really. She is a cutie pie. So, at first I thought, yes, this is awesome. Ah, the dog's putting me off. It's okay, Jesse, carry on barking. I'm just going to talk over voice anyway. So, at first I was really excited about this, and then I realised Barry M's glitter eyeliners are a bit crap. Like, there you go. As you can see, this is it here. And I've always found that it's really bitter, and if you do a big, you do a straight line, it just comes out in bits. It never comes out the way you want it to. So I'm just going to use this to like kind of mix with like the shadows and give it a bit more glitter to it, but I don't really like these things too much. They're really bitter. Let's be honest, for a tenner, I got this cute little makeup bag and shitloads of makeup. I'm not going to complain. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. That's pretty cool. And then that came in this really, really cute bag. No idea what I'm going to do for that. I'll probably end up using it for sketchbooks and stuff, but yeah. Really awesome. It's like, you're not going to get a deal like that anywhere other than the clothes show, right? So I'm glad that I did that. I need a wipe to wipe off this makeup on my hand. And then I went to their Hellooo counter, which was like covered with people. There's people obsessing over this counter, so I ran over and I was like, ooh! And I'd never actually heard of Hellooo cosmetics before. Don't shout at me. Oops. So I thought, oh, I'll go and check it out. So I went over and I spotted these really, really, really cute, like, dusts. Really shiny. I got this one in pink, this one in black, and then this gold one. Ah, the gold one is so pretty. Look how wonky and horrible my hands are. Yuck. So yeah, got all of these babies. Love, love, love. These are normally a 5 each, and then I got 3 for a 5er. Bargain or what? I just want to live at this place so much. I'm going to give you all a little swatch of them with eyeliner. Okay, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to put them all over orange eyeliner. Why orange eyeliner, Jess? Why not white eyeliner? Why not black eyeliner? Okay, I'm going to put the black one over black eyeliner, but I'm going to put the other two over this orange eyeliner just because I can. Okay. Look at that. That's just over a normal black eyeliner, and look how shiny it is. I love that. It's absolutely powerful as hell. And if you rub at it, it doesn't exactly come away very easily, does it? Pretty powerful stuff. Not bad, right? Not bad. Now for the other two. Brush those away. Look at those. Aren't they gorgeous? Absolutely gorgeous. And I actually got the pink one so I can put it on my lips. Just, I'm just imagining how like that's going to be so orgasmic when I do that. It's an orgasm there and then. And I got three of those colours for a fiver. Ah, if I had more money, I would have bought everyone. Next, I got these. What are these, you ask, Jess? What are these? Salt scrubs. Now, this lady approached me that looked like Shakira. And I was like, whoa, it's Shakira. Awesome! It wasn't Shakira. She was from Israel and she... Yeah, she wasn't Shakira, but... Because she liked Shakira, it enticed me in. And she was like, have you ever been to the Dead Sea? And I was like, no, I've never been to the Dead Sea. And she was like, I need to show you something. So we walked to the counter and she sprinkled some of this onto my hand and said, rub it in. And I was like, okay, I'll rub it in. Anyway, so I was rubbing it in. And then she was all like, okay, keep rubbing, like, it's exfoliator. So I was rubbing it all over, and it was quite rough, and I was like, arr. But then she said, okay, right, now I'm going to spray. She had this little spray bottle. Spray your hands while you rub them together. So I did so, and I'm not going to lie. The feeling was amazing. My hands actually felt like baby hands. I have this little baby brother called Damien, and that's what I imagine his bottom feels like. They always say smooth as a baby's bottom. Yep. That's how it felt. And oh my lord, I was in love there and then. And then I found out how expensive they were. 50 quid each. What? What? Now this is made by a company called KEDEM or KEDEM. And it's salt scrub with dead sea minerals, aromatic oils and Dunna layer seaweed. And I was thinking, and it's really heavy. It's quite a lot of salt in there. But as soon as I found out the price, I was like, what? I didn't want to pay it. And I was with my mum. And then my mum was like, oh, I'm not paying for that. But then as soon as she washed her hands with the salt stuff as well, she was like, oh my God. And then all I could think was imagine that feeling all over your body in the shower. Imagine it. What this actually does is it like gets rid of the dead skin cells. Like, you know, like, okay, like on our bodies, we have a layer of dead skin that's kind of invisible to the naked eye. And it comes off gradually, but this kind of takes it off a bit faster than that. And it was like, anyway, so then she said she would do four of these for 50 quid. So that's what me and my mum did. And the other night, I had a shower using this. That's what it looks like inside. And oh my God, I wish you could smell this stuff. Mmm. This is kiwi and mango flavour. And it smells amazing! It kind of smells more kiwi than mango-y. I can't even smell the mango in this, but the fact that I can smell the kiwi, it's like... And you only need the tiniest, tiniest bit, and it made my body feel amazing. Bah! I just wanted to, like, stroke my body all day long. I kind of did, but yeah. And I've not used this one in the shower yet, but I'm definitely looking forward to it. I'm going to have fun. If any of you purchase this, any of you get any of these, I'll put links to where I've got all this stuff from in like the bottom bar. But if any of you actually get this stuff and you are going to use it in the shower, only use it once a week because you don't want to like take away too much skin. Like, you've got to have a certain amount of dead skin cells and all that crap. But it could be really rough to your skin actually using this every day and every time you have a shower. So only use it once a week. And when you're putting it on your body, don't rub it around your eyes because it's a sensitive area. Only like here and down. So you can rub it here on your face, but not here. Whatever you do, don't rub it around your eyes. Bad idea. Ta-da! Massive bag of perfume. Okay, and for 20 quid, I got crap loads of perfume. Calvin Klein, some boy thing, whatever, majiggy bob. I'm not going to go into details with these because I don't really want to. But this was supposed to be £45, it even says on the back. And that's just one of the things that I got in this box. Deep Blue by Jean Christian, or Jean Christian, or whatever. Really, really pretty bottle. I got London Top Model. This is supposed to be 50 quid, as you can see on the back there. And I got that in there as well. This was supposed to be 30 quid. Ooh. Okay, you can't see the bottle through this, so I'll wipe it out. So you can have a look. Doo-doo. But I don't want to spray them again because it's very likely that I'm going to give these people for Christmas presents. So, whoop. I also got this. I don't know about you, but I hate this woman. I hate her so much. She was on this program, like if you're from America and you're watching this, called Big Brother over here, and she was so annoying. She thought she was Posh Spice. She did my lid in. Did it in completely. And this is her perfume. I think it's called Moi. I hate to say it. I absolutely hate to say it, but out of all the perfume I got in that box, I like this one the best. Look how pretty that bottle is. It's absolutely gorgeous. I'm thinking I'm keeping this one, so I'll spray this one. It's kind of like a sweetie kind of mature smell. I've never really smelled anything like it, and I hate to say it, but I really, really like it. Box fail. Box, I love the packaging, I love everything about it, apart from this. Die! I actually wish he'd die. And then I had an extra one that I gave to my dad. In this, 20 quid, £200 worth of perfume in there. That is a deal and a half. More goodies. And this is from Montagne Jeunesse or whatever, or however you say it. And they're normally about £1 each in Asda. So normally if I went to Asda, which is Walmart in America, it'd be £1 for this. So that's pretty cool. And I got 4 massive face masks. Fine line mask overnight deep rehydration thingy me jiggy bob mask thing. Dye. One night colour pink hair dye. Now, I'm probably not going to use those based on the fact that I always use vegetable dye. I got an anti-cellulite body mask. Leg polish thingy. What? Smooth leg polish. Are you having me on? Polish. Why would you even... What? Makes no sense. It hurts my brain. Leg balm that smells like cherries, apparently. Leg balm. What? Hair dye, which is like a baby pink colour. I think I might use them at Halloween or something, but I would never use them permanently. For a fiver. And then I also got this like deep hair conditioning treatment thing in there as well in a packet, and it was strawberry flavoured, but I used that the other night. My hair has never felt so soft. Pantene stand where all these people were like swooshing their hair. Best swoosh, I'll give you a swoosh now. Someone swishing their hair, and everyone could do this. Everyone could go on stage and swish their hair, and I really wanted to do it, but there's a massive queue and I really couldn't be bothered with that because I am a sucker for queues. Based on the fact that if I see a queue for something I really, really want to do, really, really want, don't care what it is, nothing is going to get me in that queue. Nothing. Unless it was Billy Joe Armstrong naked signing pictures and having sex with you. Then I'd stand in the queue. In here I got a coupon. And then I got some Pantene Aqualite shampoo and conditioner to try out. This woman just came up to me while I was staring at the queue deciding whether to stand in it or not. She came up to me and gave me it. So I got 3 lots of those. Obsession with trying things out. Bye guys.